Friends, I am Ravi Narayan Acharya from Gujarat Ayurveda University, Jamnagar. Today, in this lecture, we'll have a discussion regarding the role of vegetables as pathya in different disease conditions. And we'll also have a discussion on the classical views and the recent developments, some evidence-based studies on different vegetables in the text described in Ayurveda. As we all know, food plays a decisive role in development, sustenance, reproduction and termination of life. Sushrut have categorically told this in a verse in Sutrasthana, that is Brahma Therapicha Loka Shahara Stiti Utpatti Vinasa Hetuscha, that is food plays a decisive role in development, sustenance, reproduction and termination of life. Further, in Charaka, it has been clearly mentioned in Sutrasthana that one who takes wholesome diet lives for 36,000 nights, that is 100 years, with perfect health and great blessings from noble persons. So, these two verses, as shown in the slide, gives us the importance of ahara as described in classical text of Ayurveda. Further, diet also plays a major role, an important role in prevention of manifestations of many disease conditions. Charaka in Sutrasthana say that one should regularly take such food articles which are beneficial to maintain good health. And he quotes Tachya Nityam Rajujitam Swastham Enanuvartate Ajatanang Vikaranang Anutpattikarang Tatat. And it interferes with the pharmacological actions of prescribed drugs. It has been told that pathya, that is wholesome diet, has significant role in prevention as well as management of diseases. It has been quoted in the text that pathya sati gadatarsya kimoshadhi nishevane, pathya asati gadatarsya kimoshadhi nishevane. That is, a wholesome diet has a significant role in the prevention as well as management of disease conditions. That is, ahara, according to Ayurveda, many Ayurveda classifies the dravya into two categories. One is of ahara, another is of aushadha. And aushadha dravyas are virya pradhana, and a detailed description regarding various types of drugs, their pharmacological classifications, their their origin classification, their pharmacological properties classifications, that is, the drugs are classified according to different convenient necessities, that is, according to their pharmacological actions, properties, origin and qualities, all these things are there. But the ahara varga too also classified into different types, and among this ahara varga we have observed, that is, one in classical text of Ayurveda in different nighantus we generally found, that is gurasa varga, which describes a group of milks that is obtained from cow, buffaloes, sheep, goats, elephant, camels, and their properties has been well noted in the classical text of Ayurveda. And another burga in the under this Ahara burga, Ayurveda describes regarding the Mansa burga, the properties of various Mansa, that is meat obtained from different animals, starting from goat, chicken, and cows. All these animals has been well described and noted in the classical text of Ayurveda. We have different other cereals, that is Shimbi Burga and Shukadhanya Burga. Shimbi Dhanya and Shukadhanya, two different types of cereals. One is your pulses, and other cereals has been classified. One major classification was under this Ahara Burga is Shaka Burga. We can say as vegetables. Under this Shaka Burga, there are other subdivisions. When describing Shaka Burga, Ayurveda says there are group of Shaka whose roots are being used, that is categorized as Mula Shaka. The vegetables where the flowers are consumed, they are consumed as known as Pushpa Shaka, where the fruits are consumed either in green or in ripened conditions, they are called Phala Burga. And another is Sansvedata, that is sweat. Some plants are very few plants are categorized on this groups. And another is Nala, another is Patra, that is leaf and stem. All this Shaka Burga has been categorized into this different types. The while describing the importance of vegetables, Priyavat Sharma in his Priya Nighantu tells, Sakang dadati lavanang sajalang janibhyast twani chapi tanu jivana dharakani. The fresh vegetables are important ingredients of a healthy food. Use of different types of vegetables provides us with essential vitamins, minerals, and other essential nutrients required for the maintenance of the health. So, in the next 30 minutes, we will have a discussion regarding the vegetables mentioned in under this Shaka Burga in various classical texts of Ayurveda. And for this, in the recent lecture, I will be discussing only 15 available Nighantus and lexicons, particularly the Samhitas. So, various research journals and books where the latest research regarding the vegetables are also available will have a discussion regarding their role in prevention and management diseases. If you see this table gives us a glimpse regarding the total number of vegetables described under the heading Shaka Burga in those texts. You see, in Charak Samhita, 118 plants are categorized under Shaka Burga. Out of them, 15 categorized under fruits, 71 under leaves, 7 under flowers, 2 under the stem or nala category, and 23 under root category. Sushruta also, in Sushruta Samhita, describes 133 plants under Shaka Burga. Among this, 20 are categorized under Phala Burga, 71 under leafy vegetables, 20 as flowers vegetables, 1 and 21 in Nala and root respectively. Ashtanga Sangraha also categorized 150 plants under Shaka Burga. Among the Samhitas, Ashtanga Sangraha gives maximum reference of vegetables. Among this, 25 are fruits vegetable, 90 are leafy, 9 are flowers, and 26 of root vegetables. Ashtanga Hrudaya has also dedicated 144 plants under Schakaberger, and where he has given reference of 22 plants as phalasaka, that is fruit vegetables, 88 leafy, 2 under flowers, and 27 under root vegetables. Sodhala Nighantu, as the latest one of the very recent Nighantus, describes Guruchyadi Varga, where 51 plants with categorized under vegetable category, where 31 under fruits, 26 under leaf, 8 under pushpa, 1 under nala, and 6 under kanda. We have also plants in Madhavadrabhyaguna under Shakavarga, where 92 plants were described. Madanpala gives 61 information of plants under Shakavarga. Kaidava Nighantu, one of the major Nighantu, which is known as Pathyapathya Vibhodhika, gives us informations about vegetables under Aushadha Varga. 102 plants are categorized under this group, and that among this, 26 are phala, 55 are patra, 1 under pushpa, and 20 under kandasaka. Bhaprakasha gives under only 68 plants under Shakavarga, where 20 are fruits, 27 are patra, 3 pushpa, and 17 under kanda. Rajanighantu gives 105. Among all available Nighantus, Rajanighantu has highest number of information, next to Kaideva, which has 102. So Rajanighantu gives 15 plants under phala, 59 under patra, 2 under nala, and 23 under kanda Shakavarga. Priya Nighantu, the latest Nighantu of 20th century, gives us information about 55 plants, where 19 are phalavarga, 17 are patrasaka, 8 are pushpasaka, and 19 kandasaka. Drabhyaguna Sangraha and Drabhyaguna Satasloki gives us information about vegetables and categorize them under fruits, leaves, flowers, and root vegetables. So these are the glimpse of informations available in the different Nighantus described under Ayurveda for description of vegetables. Described each vegetables has been described with their properties and their indications, and when categorizing all these indications and the common disease comes, disease symptoms which has been highlighted, which are primary health care purpose and particularly used in the primary health care, have been highlighted in this case. Almost all the classical tests have indicated Shakavarga Drabhyas for management of prevention of certain disease conditions. Among this, we have information of 38 plants for Swasa, 35 for Kushta, 34 for Kasha. We have indication of 33 plants under Rudroga, under Prameha 29, Jura 41, and Raktapitta 53. So these are the indications. This number of plants has been highlighted for this disease condition, which is commonly prevalence in the society. Now we'll, in this lecture, we'll concentrate upon 5 disease conditions, dear friends. One, upon gastrointestinal disease conditions, where 58 plants has been indicated, under skin 49 plants, under respiratory diseases 44, and cardiovascular disease 33, and diabetes 29 plants. You can have more detailed information of these plants in the published research articles, where from this link provided in this table, in the figure. And we'll start with gastrointestinal tract, that is GIT diseases. It has been noted in the recently recent research publications that intake of vegetables is associated with symptoms onset or excavation in a significant proportion of functional gastrointestinal disorders. So, intake of vegetables is related to onset of symptoms in a significant proportion of functional gastrointestinal tract disorders. Disease like cholelithiasis, duodenal ulcer, hemorrhoids, and hiatal hernia may be prevented or treated with dietary fibers present in the vegetable. This article has been published already. High fiber diet may help to prevent colon cancer and can be used to treat constipations, diverticular diseases, irritable bowel syndrome, and Crohn's disease also. The data has been, these articles are published, the role of dietary fibers in these disease conditions. The bulking and softening action of insoluble fibers also decrease pressure inside the intestinal tract and may help to prevent diverticulosis. This was also been reported. Now we'll see different vegetables which are very commonly available and mentioned in the classical text of Ayurveda for different disease conditions related to GI tract, that is Annavasthana. We have near about 58 disease plants in the GI disorders. One among them are Ajirna, Chardi, Arsa, Grahani, and Aruchi. I am not going in detail about this English covalent of this disease conditions. So, the disease particularly in case of Ajirna, we have plants use just like Chanaka, Karkotaki, Rasuna, and Hastikarna. In case of Chardi, we have Kakamachi, Karkotaki, Sarsapa, and Polakanda, Surana. In case of Arsa, the plants, particularly Changeri, Sunnishanaka, Vastuka, and Surana are well indicated. In case of Grahani, we have Rajakoshataki, Grunjana, Changeri, and Tailaparni. And in Oruchi, particularly Dishvishya, the Arkapushpi, Brahmi, Chakramarda, Grunjana, and Kantakari are indicated. We will see some evidence-based research activities on these plants. In case of the plants such as Brahmi, Bacopamoniari, Kushmanda, Venenkasa hispida, Dumbara, Ficus racemosa, Kakamachi, Solatum nigrum has been reported for their gastroprotective activities. Central Asiatica, Gajar and Loni has been reported for their effect on ulcerative colitis. Antidiarrheal effect of Brahmi and Benincasa hispida, Kushmanda has also been reported. Inflammatory disease conditions, inflammatory bowel disease conditions, IBS, has also been the role of Rasuna and Changeri has been reported in different journals. The spasmolytic action of Surana, which is also considered as the one of the best Gandhasaka, has been reported in the different research journals. So, these are the plants which are very commonly available, and there is no controversy regarding their botanical identity and are can be taken for the management of a different disease conditions related to gastrointestinal tract. Now, dear friends, we'll discuss regarding the vegetables which can be used in respiratory diseases. It has been reported that changes in the diet over the past few decades increased the prevalence of chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, that is COPD. So, if someone changes the diet habit for consecutively for some years together, then there is a chance of COPD. Evidence from human studies and experimental investigations have shed new light on the relationship between the diet, lungs function, and COPD development, showing the role of certain foods, nutrients, and dietary patterns on pulmonary function. It has also been reported. In an article, it has been also proved that a whole foods approach to nutrients supplementations, for example, increasing intake of fruit and vegetables, has the benefit in respiratory diseases in terms of reducing risk of COPD and incidence of asthma there. So, we will see certain disease conditions reported related to respiratory tract. We have in Ayurvedic Ayurveda the disease conditions known as kasha, swasha, pratishaya, and hikka, which can be well managed through certain vegetables, that these vegetables can prevent and or manage some certain diseases related to respiratory tract. And when critically analyzing the vegetables described in those classical texts of Ayurveda, it is found that there are about 44 plants which are indicated, which are there with their role in managing different prevention and management different diseases of respiratory tract. In case of kasha, we have alabu, brahmi, and chakramarda. In case of swasha, grinjana, guruchi, and kakamachi, which are very common. And in case of pratishaya, we have the plants karavallaka, karkotaki, and kosataki. In hikka, we have the brintaka. So, these plants gives us some remedial measures for the prevention as well as management of respiratory diseases. So, because for the management of this respiratory disease conditions, drugs with antitussive activities as a bronchodilator, expectorant, anti-allergic, antioxidant, and anti-inflammatory properties are well chosen. So, the recent research shows that loni, shigru, sthitivara, karavallaka, and kashamarda are having good anti-inflammatory actions. So, this can be used in terms in managing various respiratory disease conditions. Particularly, they are indicated in the classical way for their swasahar karma and can be have their proven for their anti-inflammatory actions, so can be taken in certain disease conditions. We have antioxidant activities of mandukaparni, chakramarda, kakamachi, karavallaka, and lasuna. So, these plants parts, different plant parts of these vegetables, some of the root, leaf, are can be used for respiratory. We have kakamachi, mandukaparni, and potola, which has been reported for their anti-allergic properties. So, the respiratory tract diseases where allergens are one of the major causes, so this can give say prevention and management of this respiratory disease conditions. We have loni and sunni sanaka, we have antitussive activities, so these plants can be used. And loni in particular is that bronchodilator, and sunni sanaka as an expectorant. So, all these plants which are described in the classical text of Ayurveda and are used as a green or a vegetable and proved for their pharmacological actions, which are helpful for managing respiratory tract diseases, can be tried, and they are easily available, and there is no controversy regarding their botanical identifications. They should be collected from a well place and used for management of this disease conditions. Now we'll discuss regarding vegetables used for cardiovascular diseases. The plants which provide nutrients such as fibers, foliate, potassium, carotenoids and other phytochemicals may directly reduce cardiovascular disease risk. So, certain nutrients may directly improve established diet-related cardiovascular disease risk factors such as blood pressure, hyperlipidemia and diabetes. The consumption of vegetables may lead to a reduced intake of saturated fat and cholesterol. So, the plants which are known as a vegetable and reported in the classical text of Ayurveda for their use as a vegetables and have proved with this type of pharmacological actions can be taken for the prevention and management of certain diseases, cardiovascular diseases. In the classical text of Ayurveda, of this we have more than near about 33 plants which are indicated for different cardiovascular diseases, and among this some are patra, pushpa and phala. We saw that the patra shaka, that is brahmi, chakramadha, guruchi, methi and punarnava, these are indicated for their actions, and pushpa, that is bakula and nimba. Under the fruit category we have alabu, karavallaka, karputaki, kosataki, kushmanda and shigru. These plants are used, that is highlighted for their use in different diseases related to cardiovascular disease in the classical text of Ayurveda. And while going through the recent published research papers, it is found that rasuna, Benincasa hispida, that is your kushmanda, Boravia diffusa, punarnava, gurjana, dicarotea and your methika has proved for their cardioprotective activities, and anti-hypertensive activities. Also Allium sativum, that is rasuna, Central Asiatica, Azadirachta indica, Mammotia charentia, that is your Dioica potula, Methica are also proved for their anti-hypertensive actions. So, these plants can be consumed for patients which are for the prevention and management of certain cardiovascular disease conditions. These are where in the diuretic activities is needed. The plants like Allium sativum, Benincasa hispida and Methica can also be used for that purpose. We have antiplatelet activities, certain plants such as Allium sativum and other plants, Central Asiatica, are proved for their antiplatelet activities. This can be considered there. Anti-hyperlipidemic activities of punarnava, mandukopani and karavallaka, potula and kushmanda, lasuna are also proved. So these plants, when collected from a good source, can be taken for the their preventive and curative aspect of different disease conditions related cardiovascular diseases. In Ayurveda also plants has been highlighted for their different disease conditions including prameha, and in vegetables in the prevention, prameha diabetes is being closely correlated with madhumeha, one of the variety of prameha. So vegetables in the prevention of type 2 diabetes tends to be associated with the fiber found in the vegetables. Dietary fibers helps to slow the release of sugar into the bloodstream, thus helping to keep the blood sugar levels normal. So plants with high dietary fibers should be consumed as a vegetable. Soluble fibers delay the glucose absorption from the small intestine and thus may help prevent the spike in the blood glucose levels. Follow a milk or snack. The latest scientific evidence also provides greater support for the role of vegetables in protecting different diseases. Studies also show that greater intake of green leafy vegetables was associated with 14% reduction in the risk of type 2 diabetes. So there are certain researches and scientific background that vegetables has role in prevention and certainly something management of diabetes. In Ayurveda, there are descriptions of certain plants as vegetables which are indicated for different management of diabetes. And in the classical text, there are near about 29 plants which are used as vegetables have been highlighted for their anti-diabetic actions. Among them, alabu, brahmi, chakramarda, grinjana, guduchi, kakamachi, karavallaka, karputaki, kusataki, kushmanda, lashuna, methika, nimba, punarnava and vrintaka. These are very common vegetables, are very frequently available in the market, and they are noted for their anti-diabetic actions in the classical text of Ayurveda and can be consumed. The classical vegetables which are reported for their anti-diabetic activity are Central Asiatica, that is in Ayurveda it is called as Mandukapanni, Marmodia charantia, that is Karavallaka, Marmodia dioica, that is Karkotaki, and Lupha acutangula, that is Kosataki, Trichosanthus dioica, that is Patola, and Patulacea oleracea, that is Loni. So these are the plants which are reported for their anti-diabetic activities. So this they can be consumed, the patients can consume, those who are having diabetes, they can consume these vegetables for this purpose. So again, we'll discuss regarding another disease conditions which is very prevalent in the society, that is the skin diseases. So dermatologic conditions linked with nutrition can range from nutritional deficiency, excess nutrients or metabolic disorders. There are certain disorders where one or more components in food are central to the pathogenesis, for example, dermatitis herpetiformis. A brief list of other disorders where diet may have a role to play include atopic dermatitis, as in vulgaris, psoriasis vulgaris, urticaria, pruritus, allergic contact dermatitis, fish odor syndrome, toxic oil syndrome, fixed drug eruptions, vitiligo, and cutaneous vasculitis, and etc. So in Ayurveda, maximum plants, near about 49 plants are categorized under Shakabarga, are indicated for management of different skin disease conditions such as kandu, kushta, pisharpa, vishpota and vidradhi. These are the certain skin disease conditions described in the classical text of Ayurveda. Kandu, that is a common itching that plants like chakramarda, brihati, kantakari, sarsapa, patha and kakajangha are indicated for their, are highlighted for their kandugna properties and can be indicated for this disease conditions. And particular other skin disease conditions such as Brahmi, Changeri, Chakramarda, Guduchi and Potola are known for their Kushtagna karma, and so that can be implemented different skin disease conditions. And Visharpa particularly, Hansapadi and Sigruj highlighted, and but Pishpota, Shubarchala, and in case of Vidradhi, we have Sigru and Simbi highlighted in the classical text of Ayurveda for their action on Vidradhi. So, in skin disease conditions, we know various pharmacological actions such as antioxidant, plants with antioxidant, anti-inflammatory, immunomodulatory, and anti-allergic plays a role in different skin disease conditions. So, plants such as Potola, Kadali, Loni, Vrintaka, and Karabilaka which are proved for their antioxidant properties, and plants like Lashuna, Chakramarda, Mandukaparni, and Hilamochika, which are known, reported for their anti-inflammatory activities, can be considered for treating different skin diseases for the prevention and management of patients suffering from skin diseases. Plants like Potola, Lashuna, Karabilaka and Kantarakari has been proved for their immunomodulatory activities. And this immunomodulatory activity, plants with which boost the immunity, can be helpful in prevention and also management of certain skin diseases. Plants like Mandukaparni, Potola and Kakamachi are known for their anti-allergic actions, and as many skin diseases are known due to certain allergen, so this plants Mandukaparni, Potola can be taken for a treatment of or prevention or cure effective aspect of different skin disease conditions. So, dear friends, in conclusion, it can be said that from the history of medicine to the recent modern researches, among the preventive measures given to the persons suffering from different diseases, Shakavarga Dravyas have proven their role and importance in this area. However, the scientific claim to prove this claim in a scientific way, a large scale trials, clinical trials should be conducted, and to establish their role in the prevention and management of this disease condition. Though classical text of Ayurveda says their role in this disease conditions, they must be proved through a scientific study, and this plants good collection practice and good the storage practice must be followed while preparing different vegetables. The vegetables which are collected from the natural sources must be clean and properly washed, very thoroughly checked for any infections, because Shaka is also in different classical texts, Shaka has been not recommended as a routine diet because due to infection, because they are prone to infection from the ground, certain infectants and certain fungal infections or other infected by this surrounding. So, they might be washed properly. In the meantime, the available evidence supports a diet rich in vegetables serves an appropriate strategy to reduce the risk of many disorders. Thanks.